Cape Zamfir. Labar. Thank you. Schaefer. Katzman. Klein. Tyson and Pepsi, gotta have it. R. Renner. Janipour. C. Renner. Zafiratis.
There's the whistle beginning the first semifinal game. Teams, you're playing for a videotape bonus, and here's your audio toss-up. Listen and identify this group performing an early 1970s FM favorite. Is the Sopwith Camel. Still playing for that videotape bonus. Here's your toss-up. Film director Tim Burton has not made it a secret that his favorite actor is Vincent Price.
Zamfir Klein.
He cast him as the creator in Edward Scissorhands.
Edward Scissorhands is right. Okay, Zamfir, time is out. Identify the three groups performing the same song and the original group who sang it for 10 points each. Time's back in, Zamfir, your list.
Okay, it's the Beatles for the first one, Otis Day and the Knights for the second, the Kinks for the third.
That was the Animals.
Yeah, the Animals, and
the Isley Brothers.
The Isley Brothers is right. You have 3 for 30 points. Okay, teams, you're playing now for a 30-point bonus, and here's the toss-up. Although he had regular roles on Annie McGuire, Lucas Tanner, and Grand, this actor has made an art form of the recurring father role, most notably as Emily's father on The Bob Newhart Show, and more recently as Roseanne's...
Tyson C. Renner.
Barnard Hughes.
5-point penalty, a repeat for the other team. Although he has regular roles on Annie McGuire, Lucas Tanner, and Grand, this actor has made an art form of the recurring father role, most notably Emily's father in The Bob Newhart Show, and more recently, Roseanne's father on Roseanne. Name this busy actor. He is John Randolph. You're still playing for that 30-point bonus. Here's the toss-up. What was the only thing that stayed in Pandora's box after she opened it?
Tyson C. Renner.
Hope.
Hope is right for 10 points. Okay. Here's the bonus, Tyson. Sports body language bonus. In baseball, many of the great hitters have unique tics, routines, or gestures which have made them unforgettable. For 10 points each, one member of your team needs to step forward and perform the trademark move of the following players. Babe Ruth facing Charlie Root in the 1923 series.
Do we have to get up? Or?
Sure, why not?
Yes.
All right, I'll accept that. Rod Carew.
Crouch.
Okay, we'll take that. Wide stance, bat held low. Joe Morgan. Okay, we accept that. That is the chicken flap. Okay, we'll take that. All three of those for 30 points. Okay, teams, you're playing now for a 30-point bonus. Here's a toss-up. Country singers George Jones and Mark Chestnut both call what Texas community their hometown?
Zamfir Katzman.
Austin.
No, can you take it, Tyson?
Tyson R. Renner.
Lubbock.
No, it's Beaumont, Texas. Still playing for that 30-point bonus. Here is the toss-up. What pitcher was victimized by George Brett's famous pine tar home run in 1982?
Zamfir Schaefer.
Dave Rigetti.
No, can you take it, Tyson?
Tyson C. Renner.
Ron Guidry.
No, it's a Goose Gossage. You're still playing for that bonus. Here is the toss-up. At the end of the opening theme to the classic TV series Green Acres, Oliver and Lisa Douglas appear in a scene which parodies...
Tyson C. Renner.
American Gothic by Grant Wood.
By Grant Wood, that is right. Okay, Tyson, here's the bonus. Several members of the Marvel Comics mutant group, the X-Men, are of international origin. For 10 points each, identify the home country of the following. Colossus.
Soviet Union.
All right. Nightcrawler.
West Germany. Germany.
Fine. Oh, that's fine. I should say the former Soviet Union. Sheesh.
Former West Germany.
Wolverine.
Canada.
You have all three of those. 30 points. Teams, you're now playing for an audio bonus. Here's the toss-up. Dwight Yoakam, John Prine, Joe Ely, James McMurtry, and John Mellencamp sing together on Mellencamp's tune Sweet Suzanne for Mellencamp's recent film Falling from Grace. What is the name of this hobnob music band? They are the Buzzin' Cousins. You're still playing for that audio bonus. Here's the toss-up. In the 1991 film Barton Fink, a Clifford Odets-type character played by John Turturro is brought to 40s Hollywood to write a screenplay for what real-life actor?
Zamfir Klein.
It's Wallace Beery. That's a wrestling movie.
That's right. I needed both of those. That is right for 10 points. All right, with time out, Zamfir. For 10 points apiece, identify the movies which featured the following four songs.
On your a Catholic the moment God came, because every sperm is sacred, every sperm is great. If a sperm is wasted, God gets quite irate.
That should be a
sign. At the round table, three dots where we're able. We do routine to call the scenes, to footwork in bed cable. We dine well here in Camelot, we eat ham and jam and spam a lot.
The life gets you down, Mrs. Brown. And things seem hard or tough. And people are stupid, obnoxious or daft. And you feel that you've had quite enough. Just remember that you're standing on a planet that's evolving, revolving at 900 miles an hour. Things in life are bad, they can really make you mad. Other things just make you swear and curse. When you're chewing on life's gristle, don't grumble, give a whistle, and this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side of life.
Okay, time is back in.
Okay, for the first we have Monty Python's The Meaning of Life. Second one is Monty Python and the Holy Grail. The third one is also Monty Python's The Meaning of Life. And the fourth one is Monty Python's Life of Brian.
That's right, you have all four for 40 points. Teams, you're playing now for a visual bonus. Here's a toss-up. Call to Glory, Dallas, Lost Precinct, Troubleshooters were TV series that featured the talents of what actor who also served as host of the anthology of reruns entitled The Westerners, but will probably be most remembered in TV lore as Maish, Mount McClintock's manager in Playhouse 90's Requiem for a Heavyweight?
Zamfir Klein.
That would be... Ed Wynn.
No, can you take it, Tyson?
Tyson C. Renner.
Howard Keel.
It is Keenan Wynn. Keenan Wynn. You're still playing for that visual bonus. Here's an audio toss-up. Listen and identify these rockers who were popular during the late 70s and throughout the 80s and the song they're performing.
Zamfir Katzman.
Can you take it, Tyson?
Tyson Janipour.
That's REO Speedwagon, Roll with the Changes.
Roll with the Changes, that is right. Okay, will you now look at the screen and name the four women artists associated here with new folk music?
Michelle Schacht.
That.
Joni Mitchell.
Sarah Hickman. Sean Colvin.
Is that Phoebe Snow?
Maura O'Connell, you have one for 10 points. All right, teams, you're playing now for a 30-point bonus. Here's the toss-up. This musician had a checkered career, starting out in the Palace Guard, fronted the merry-go-round, recorded several McCartney sound-alike LPs in the 70s, and even produced Gabe Kaplan's Up Your Nose 45. Name this baby-faced L.A. popster.
Tyson C. Renner.
Paul Williams.
No, can you take it, Zamfir? It is Emmett Rhodes, Emmett Rhodes. You're still playing for that 30-point bonus. Here is the toss-up. Name both of the pro teams Jim Plunkett played for prior to...
Zamfir Klein.
New England.
Klein.
That would be New England Patriots and...
Got to throw it out. No. Conference.
Conference, 5-point penalty. I'll repeat for Tyson. Name both of the pro teams Jim Plunkett played for prior to joining the Oakland Raiders.
Tyson Janipour.
The New England Patriots and the San Francisco 49ers.
That is right for 10 points. Now, your bonus, Tyson, for 10 points each, name all of the three available flavors of Kraft Cheese Whiz. Could I have your answer, please?
Original, nacho, and jalapeno.
All right. I'm sorry. They are regular, mild Mexican, and hot jalapeno. No points.
No.
Okay, teams, you're playing for an audio bonus. Here's the toss-up. George Bush and Dan Quayle were members of the same college fraternity. Which one was it?
Zamfir Schaefer.
Sigma Alpha Epsilon.
No, can you take it, Tyson?
Tyson C. Renner.
Sigma Chi.
No, they're Delta Kappa Epsilon. They may be dorks, but they were also deeks, it says here. All right, teams, you're still playing for that audio bonus. Here's the toss-up. There always seems to be too much violence on TV and in the movies, and had Beauty and the Beast won Best Picture, it would have become the first film rated G to win the award since...
Tyson C. Renner.
Since Oliver.
Oliver is right. Okay, time is out. Here's a medley dedicated to one of the Trivia Bowl's most revered fans. Mama Elkins, identify these artists or groups for 10 points apiece.
Who's the one who tied your shoe when you were young and knew just when to come and see what you had done, Mama? Oh, Mama. My mama didn't lie, she didn't lie, mama didn't lie, she didn't lie.
Mama said, mama said, I said, mama, mama said,
okay, time is back in, Tyson.
We only have Genesis for the second one.
Okay, the first was B.J. Thomas and Jan Bradley doing Mama Didn't Lie, the Vaughn Brothers, so you have 10 points. Teams, you're playing for a visual bonus now. Here's a toss-up. The short existence of the American Basketball Association was punctuated by the presence of some odd individuals. One prominent player once refused to get on an airplane in Louisville, which would land at an earlier time in St. Louis after gaining an hour back, proclaiming, "I ain't getting in no time machine." Who is this genius member of the Spirits of St. Louis?
Tyson C. Redder.
Marvin Barnes.
Who else? Marvin Barnes is right. All right. Look at the screen now, Tyson and Ugg. Try and name these four famously terrible movies who were part of the 50 worst films of all time for 10 points apiece.
Johnny Guitar?
No, that's, I don't know how to pronounce this. Ega.
Ega.
Plan 9 from Outer Space?
Okay, I have Vampira here. Is that the name of the movie? Plan 2, Plan 9. Okay, we'll give you Plan 9 from Outer Space. She's in it, certainly.
The Frozen Dead?
No, that's Glenn or Glenda. And finally,
Robot Monster.
Yeah, Robot Monster's right. You have 2 for 20 points. All right, teams, you're playing now for a 40-point bonus. Here is the toss-up. James Brown's hit song, It's a Man's World, has recently resurfaced with lead vocals going to singer-bassist Jonette of Napoliano's Joplin-esque voice. Name the group who released his soul classic cover. That is Concrete Blonde. You're still playing for that 40-point bonus. Here is the toss-up. If you are the equipment manager for the UTSC basketball team, you're likely to get fired. This is because you've somehow forgotten to pack your entire team's basketball shoes, almost forcing them to forfeit the big game. Fortunately, the shoes show up just before starting time, courtesy of what company?
Tyson Zeferatus.
United Parcel Service.
UPS is right. Okay, and here is your bonus. For 10 points each, identify the film director who was profiled in each of the following recent biographical books. Hurricane Billy.
Billy Wilder.
No, that's William Friedkin. Bloody Sam.
Sam Peckinpah.
A Double Life.
John Huston.
That'd be George Cukor. And finally, All His Jazz.
Bob Fosse.
Bob Fosse's right. You have 2 for 20 points. All right, teams, you're playing now for a 40-point bonus. Here is the toss-up. Shadows Run Black, Night Shift, Stacy's Nights, The Gun Runner, and Table for Five were the first 5 films that were released featuring what current superstar?
Tyson Zeferatus.
Michael Keaton.
No, can you take it, Zamfir?
Zamfir Katzman.
Henry Winkler.
No, it's Kevin Costner. You're still playing for that toss-up or bonus. Here's the toss-up. What Baltimore Colts running back was known as a human bowling ball?
Zamfir Schaefer.
You may answer.
Tom Matty.
No, it is Don Nottingham. And there's the whistle ending the first half with the score. Zamfir 185, Tyson 85.
Don't forget, at 9 o'clock tonight, we're going to have the a cappella group, the 17th Avenue All-Stars. Kill the bubble machine again, please. We're drowning up here.
A trip to the market, to bed to the pearl gray morning sunlight. It settles over Washington. A trip to the market, a trip around the world. Maybe there's a negotiation if there is one. This is a lonely, lonely life. Sorrows everywhere you turn.
And that's what sounds like. That's worth some money. That's worth some money. That's worth some money.
Summer sky stars falling along the Indian coast. And if I have money, if I have children, summer sky stars are falling all along the Indian coast. Wow, wow, do wow, do wow. Summer sky stars are falling all along the Indian coast. Wow, wow, do wow, do wow. Summer sky stars are falling.
We really have to make.
I learned that.
We'd like to thank our sponsors, Bud Light, Albums on the Hill, a few others, Abo's Pizzas. Really.
Okay, teams, 30 seconds.
I'm working. I gotta work.
Hi, guys.
Okay, you see why?
There's the whistle beginning the second half. Teams, remember the next time you hear that whistle, the game will end. If I'm asking a question, I'll stop. If you're answering a question, you can answer that one question only. You're playing for a videotape bonus, and here is your audio toss-up. Listen and identify this distinctive group from yesteryear.
Zamfir Klein.
Sons of the Pioneers.
No, can you take it, Tyson?
Tyson C. Renner.
Herb Alpert and the Tijuana Brass.
No, those are their Harmonic Cats. The Harmonic Cats. Still playing for that videotape bonus. Here is the toss-up. Singer Perry Farrell masterminded last year's Lollapalooza tour and former frontman for Jane's Addiction will unveil his new band at an upcoming AIDS Foundation benefit in L.A. What name will Perry's new group go by? They are Porno for Pyros. You're still playing for that videotape bonus, and here is the toss-up. In Chinatown, Jack Nicholson shows Burt Young photos he took of Young's wife indulging in compromising sex acts. But Bob Hoskins does worse in Who Framed Roger Rabbit by showing poor Roger photos.
Zamfir Klein.
She's playing Patty Cake.
That's right. She's playing Patty Cake with another man. Okay, Zamfir, with timeout, identify these classic bad movies for 10 points apiece, along with the current cable show where each are regularly ridiculed.
It's Mystery Science Theater 3000.
Negative.
He's so negative.
Is there a choice between a painless surrender death and the horror of resistance death?
Oh, I didn't know the death ray had two settings.
By your clock time, in 1 hour, I seek you out.
The screen turned back into a refrigerator.
Mommy, why doesn't he like people?
He likes most people. It's just you he hates.
I don't know, darling.
He's not alone.
If we could talk to him.
Well, that basket is good for him. She's really got a shiny coat. The hypo glow.
Jingle and jingle and wriggle and rock. Jingle and wiggle and wiggle and rock.
She's just reading the stage directions.
Wiggle and rock. Slip and slide away.
Nice lighting.
Oh, jiggle and wiggle and wriggle and rock. Jiggle and wiggle and wriggle and rock. Jiggle and wiggle and wiggle.
who caused all that trouble at Attica. Yikes.
You're so sure you're my desire, but you should be told.
I'm in love.
Even with a blazing fire,
really
you would leave me cold. But you're a slimy baby as a salamander, slip and slide away.
Why am I here, you guys?
You're as tricky as a salamander. I don't
this just validated my existence.
She uses more peroxide in her hair than an entire MASH unit.
Salamander, salamander.
One more. What? We're queuing ahead here.
I got 12:31.
Maybe sooner than that.
I'm going presto, baboom.
Santa, that clock stopped.
60 seconds. That must be the door timer.
Have you two ever seen a grown man scream? Santa's gonna whimper like a whipped pup.
Oh, I don't think so. He probably just stepped off for a moment.
You're living in denial, Santa. Wake up and smell the coffee.
He's not like Kira and the others.
I don't like him.
I'm worried, Santa.
Now, children, let's not get excited.
Help! Help!
Now, what would MacGyver do?
Okay, time is back in. First, the movies.
The first movie is Robot Monsters.
Once again, yes.
The second movie, we're going to guess How to Stuff a Wild Bikini.
That's an Untamed Youth.
Third one is Santa Claus Conquers the Martians.
Right, and finally the TV show?
Mystery Science Theater 3000.
That's right, you have 3 for 30 points. Hey, teams, you're playing now for a 40-point bonus, and here is a toss-up. We all know that the best-known book about CU football is a stirring epic From Ashes to Glory, written by Bill McCartney. However, an earlier book written about CU football actually discusses football and not the author's disjointed view of life.
Zamfir Schaefer.
It's CU Cassati Uncensored by Fred Cassati.
Oh, 5-point penalty, I'll repeat for the other team. We all know that the best-known book about CU football is a stirring epic From Ashes to Glory written by Bill McCartney. However, an earlier book written about CU football actually discusses football and not the author's disjointed view of life. Written by Fred Cassati, what is the name of this 1972 chronicle of CU football? That is football CU style. You're still playing for that 40-point bonus. Here's the toss-up. Name the political party formed by Italian porn star La Cicolina and Muana Polsi.
Zamfir Katzman.
The fascist movie star party.
No, can you take it, Tyson?
Tyson Zapparatus.
The free love party?
No, it's the party of love. The party of love. You're still playing for that bonus. Here's the toss-up. The Colorado Buffaloes had to settle for the Blockbuster Bowl last year while the Nebraska Cornhuskers went to the Orange Bowl. But what bowl game did Hayden Fox's Minnesota State...
Zamfir Klein.
That was the Pineapple Bowl.
Yes, they went to the Pineapple Bowl. Okay, here's your bonus, Zamfir. For 10 points each, identify the country from which these beers are imported. Carlsberg.
Denmark.
That's right. Fisher.
Canada.
No, that's France. Chimay, whatever. Don't drink it.
China.
No, that's Belgium. Amstel Light.
Holland.
That's right, you have 2 for 20 points. Okay, teams, you're playing for a visual bonus now. Here's a toss-up. When Mike Powell broke Bob Beamon's world record in the long jump at the 1991 World Championships, it marked the first time Carl Lewis had been defeated in that event in over 10 years. Prior to Powell, who was the last man to defeat Lewis? It is
Zamfir Schaefer.
Bob Beamon?
No, can you take it, Tyson? It is Larry Myricks. You're still playing for that visual bonus. Here's the toss-up. In what film would the sultry Kathleen Turner say, "I never forget a face, especially if I've sat on it," to Anthony Perkins?
Zamfir Klein.
Crimes of Passion.
Crimes of Passion is right. Okay, well, you look at the screen. Here's some of the most sensational catches in World Series history. It's for 5 points each. Name the person catching the ball. 5 points more, the person who hit it.
George Foster hit it. Joe Rudy caught it.
Joe Rudy caught it. Dennis Menke hit it.
That's Sandy Alomar catching it and Yogi Berra hitting it.
That's Sandy Amoros catching it. Yogi Berra hit it.
You know, if Ken were here, he would know it.
Yeah. Joe DiMaggio hit it.
No, that's Ron Swoboda, or Swoboda, and Brooks Robinson hit the ball. And finally,
Willie Mays catching it, Vic Wertz hit it.
Okay, you have 20 points. 20 points. Okay, teams, you're now playing for a 40-point bonus. Here is the toss-up. Singer Peter Himmelman mixes soul-barking, confessional narratives with humorous stories and quirks like passing out Play-Doh to the audience. What Minneapolis band did Himmelman spend his time with in the early 1980s? It is Sussman Lawrence. You're still playing for that bonus. Here's the toss-up. Atlantic City streets are the inspirational names for Monopoly. In a trend to rename streets after Martin Luther King, what Atlantic City street, also on a Monopoly board, has changed its name?
Zamfir Klein.
Park Avenue?
No. Can you take it, Tyson? It is Illinois Avenue. You're still playing for that 40-point bonus. Here's the toss-up. It was the name of a top 20 single for Leon Russell in 1972 and the title of a 1984 Clint Eastwood film, but TV buffs...
Zamfir Klein.
Tightrope.
Tightrope is what we're looking for. That is correct. Here's your bonus, Zamfir. Recently, the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame brought together 9 legendary guitarists on one stage for 40 points, 5 points each. Name any 8 of the 9 pickers who posed together at the induction ceremonies for a Rolling Stone portrait. Could I have your list, please?
Eric Clapton, Jeff Beck, Wes Paul, Chuck Berry, Chet Atkins, Keith Richards,
and Mark Knopfler.
Okay. All right, you have 10 points for Jeff Beck and Keith Richards, Steve Cropper, Robbie Robertson, B.B. King, Jimmy Page, Carlos Santana, The Edge, and John Fogerty. 10 points. Okay, teams, you're playing for an audio bonus now, and here is the toss-up. A Guide to Western Civilization, or My Story, is just one of the books authored by what newspaper columnist and movie critic?
Zamfir Klein.
Bob Thomas.
No, can you take it, Tyson?
Tyson C. Renner.
Rex Reed.
No, it's Joe Bob Briggs. Oh. You're still playing for that bonus. Here is the toss-up. The Immaculate Reception is the tag name of the winning play of the 1972 AFC playoff game in which a Terry Bradshaw pass bounced off Jack Tatum into the hands of Franco Harris.
Zamfir Schaefer.
They beat the Oakland Raiders.
5 point penalty. Repeat for Tyson. The Immaculate Reception is the tag name of the winning play of the 1972 AFC playoff game in which a Terry Bradshaw pass bounced off Jack Tatum into the hands of Franco Harris, who ran for the winning touchdown. Tatum always disputed the call, claiming the play was an illegal catch and that the pass was actually deflected off what Steeler he was covering.
Tyson C. Renner.
John Stallworth.
No, it's Frenchie Fuqua. You're still playing for that audio bonus, and here is the toss-up. What former Spandau Ballet songwriter can be seen playing manager to Whitney Houston's singer-actress character and adversary to Kevin Costner's title character in the film The Bodyguard? That is Gary Kemp. You're still playing for that bonus. Here's a toss-up. Who wrote the novels Pride of the Bimbos and Union Dues, created the TV show Shannon's Deal, and directed...
Zamfir Klein.
John Sayles.
John Sayles is right for 10 points. All right, teams, time is out. Listen first to this.
Well, you know you love me, baby. Still, you tell me maybe that someday will I'll be through.
All right, that is, of course, Buddy Holly and the Crickets doing one of their biggest hits. For a possible 40 points, sing the chorus.
Well, that'll be the day when I say, when you say goodbye. Well, that'll be the day when you make me cry. Yeah, that'll be the day when you say goodbye. That'll be the day when I die.
Okay, 30 points. You missed the third line. 30 points. So with time back out, let's listen to how it should have been done.
Well, that'll be the day when you say goodbye. Yes, that'll be the day when you make me cry. You say you're gonna leave. You know it's a lie, 'cause that'll be the day when I die.
Okay, time is back in, and you're playing for a visual bonus once again, teams, and here is the toss-up. Chuck Knox's return as head coach of the Los Angeles Rams isn't so unusual when you consider that the Rams once, during the 1960s, fired a head coach, only to take him back after a player protest, and later fire him and hire him a second time, and then fire him in preseason. Who is he?
Tyson C. Renner.
Tommy Prothrow.
No, can you take it, Zamfir?
Zamfir Schaefer.
George Allen?
Yes, George Allen is right. All right, well, you look at the screen, and in honor of the 25th anniversary of Star Trek, identify the four actresses pictured here with the William Kennedy Smith of the 22nd century. Okay, can we start up or left?
Julie Parrish.
That's Yvonne Craig. Upper right.
No.
Sabrina Scharf. Lower left.
Francis.
That's Sherry Jackson. Finally, lower right.
Grace Lee Whitney.
You have 10 points. All right, teams, you're playing. Let's play once again for a visual bonus. And here's your audio toss-up. Listen and name the Tony Award winner who wrote this oddity early in his career.
Zamfir Klein.
Andrew Lloyd Webber.
No, can you take it, Tyson? That was written by Rupert Holmes. That is Timothy by the Boys. You're still playing with that visual bonus. Here's a toss-up. The hardest ticket to get for the London stage in 1992 is, understandably, an Andrew Lloyd Webber production. Surprisingly, however, this production is actually a revival of his very first...
Zamfir Klein.
That's Joseph and his amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat.
All right, well, I'll accept that. Joseph and his amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat is right. Okay, well, you look at the screen again, Zamfir. Identify these Disney World or Disneyland attractions for 10 points apiece.
It's a Small World.
Isn't it?
Pirates of the Caribbean. the Great Runaway Yukon Locomotive.
That's a Big Thunder Railway, and finally...
something?
Yeah.
Country Bear Jamboree?
Yeah.
Country Bear Jamboree.
That's right. You have 3 for 30 points. All right, teams, you're playing now for a 30-point bonus. Here's a toss-up. When Marvin Davis on 20th Century Fox, he used what real-life event that was run by his wife as an excuse to bring together the cast of Dynasty?
Zamfir, Klein.
The Carousel Ball.
Carousel Ball in Denver is right. And now here is your bonus. I'll name a color on the Monopoly board. You name only the only one of three avenues comprising that color. There's a whistle ending the game with the score. Zamfir 305, Tyson 185. Could we have a nice round of applause for Tyson? I have their score.